up is someone you'll have seen knocking around lots of demos around the country. It's Michael Green. He wants to talk to you.
Apologies for my voice. Some of you know why it sounds the way it does. I want to thank Mel for adding me to this. I'm going to come at this from a completely different perspective today. How many of you here have been called extremist or radicals? Put your hands up. And how many of you are proud of that? Fantastic. How many of you could look back in your life and pinpoint defining moments in your life where something happened that you changed so much in so many different ways? Come on, don't be afraid. Most of us have. That's why we're here. Okay, so I'm going to come at this from that perspective, but before I do, is there anyone here who's heard of Doris Lessing? Okay, I want to read you something that Doris Lessing wrote. Ideally, what should be said to every child repeatedly throughout his or her school life is something like this. You're in the process of being indoctrinated. We have not yet evolved a system of education that is not a system of indoctrination. We are sorry, but it is the best we can do. What you are being taught here is an amalgam of current prejudice and the choices of this particular culture. The slightest look at history will show how impermanent these must be. You are being taught by people who have been able to accommodate themselves to a regime of thought laid down by their predecessors. It's a self-perpetuating system. Those of you who are more robust and individual than others will be encouraged to leave and find ways of educating yourself, educating your own judgments. Those that stay must remember always and all the time that they are being moulded and patterned to fit into the narrow and particular needs of this particular society. So now, I want to go back to what I said about those life-changing moments. I'm just going to name a couple, two or three for me. First one was when I stopped watching television in 1999. I stopped allowing having that corporate-owned bullshit thrust into my head. Next one was when I quit smoking and drinking and doing weed. And the next one was when I started painting. And then the next one was because I'd already become an activist. Was when I became vegan. It was May the 25th, 2013, because then not only did I become vegan, but I became an activist for every living being on this planet. We're all animals. We have to see each other as connected to each other, and that I was going to be able to help other people, and I didn't know how it was going to happen. The next biggest life-changing moment for me was April the 2nd this year. There are a number of you here who know already, but I was diagnosed with non-Hodgkins stage 3 lymphoma, and a lot of people would say, oh, you're going to go down that route. And this is where I'm coming from here today. I am not going down the conventional route. They treat the symptom. They don't deal with the root cause. I don't want to be treated by people that are experimenting on other animals. I don't want to take drugs that are causing us harm, and obviously the fact that they've been experimented or produced because of animal experimentation, that's another reason why I'm not going to do it. But one of the biggest reasons is because I am so sick and tired of people in authority who really know nothing other than the lies that they've been taught from the people that own them and bribe them to pass the things that happen in this country and all around the world. And we've had speakers here today who have told you about people who have lost their lives, people who have given up their freedom. Think about that. It would be disingenuous of me to take something from the very system that opposes us. We have to stop being system apologists. We have to start looking outside of it. We've heard Peter Egan talk about it, money. Everyone knows that money is what's causing and driving all these behaviors. There's nothing wrong with science. But when corporations are using it for their benefit and others are being oppressed, whether they're other animals or the human animals, and we're all suffering, then we've got to start looking at other ways in which to do this. So my route is that I've changed my diet. I'm now fully raw. I'm going to use medicinal cannabis. I'm going to be looking into other issues, because I see this as probably the most positive life-changing moment, because I'm going to use it to make my activism even more powerful, because I'm going to come at it from now I'm going to show you that this is the healthy way to live. This is the way that we can live without exploiting animals for vivisection, for food, for clothes, for sport, that we don't exploit anyone. So, I don't want to go on too much more, because this isn't about me, but it's how I'm going to help change the world, because I'm going to write a book about it, putting down so much stuff that it will help more and more people. The last thing is that there's a young woman here who set up a fund for me. It's a GoFundMe thing. Please have a look on my page. Help me if you want to be part of this scientific experiment, because that's what it is. No animal's going to suffer me, just me. I'm the experiment. I'm going to show this is how science works, and I'm going to do it on me. And leading on from the GoFundMe, I will be setting up a supporters page also, because someone suggested it, so that I can keep you in the loop, because anyone here who has sent me a message and I haven't gone back to you yet, I do apologise. I've had so much on hospital appointments and other things, and going to see friends and answering messages as well, but I haven't been able to get around to you all. So if I set up a supporters group, that way you can all be in the link and you can find out how things are going on. But thank you very much for listening and taking the time. But I want to thank Mel and everyone else for being here today, because this has to be where we all start working together and we all start freeing up every animal on this planet so that all of us can live free. Thank you.